there, Scorpio, and welcome to your March 2020 horoscope, where Scorpio, this month, not only do we have Mercury in retrograde, but it's also coming out of retrograde. We've got Venus coming back home into the energy of Taurus, lighting up your seventh house zone. So this is definitely a time for you where you're going to see some unexpected things in relationships. We know that relationships have been a little unstable, or they've just been different. Something's been very different about them lately. But as Venus moves up there, she's going to look to bring a little harmony, a little equality, and a little sensuality to your relationships. We've also got Saturn moving into the energy of Aquarius and the spring equinox. So it's a busy month, but the best thing about this month, I think, is that it is full permission to begin moving things forward. In January and February, we were shifting, coming into new information, needing to gather information, and now we get to take that information and make it applicable to activities moving forward. So I want to bring your attention first, before we actually jump into the forecast, to where the predominance of planets are at. As you can see, most of them are towards the bottom of the chart here, and they're moving towards this right side of the chart, right? So as we're looking at that, what that is an indicator of is you are regrounding, creating some foundational level things so that you can also add those into relationships. So I think about building or developing social skills so you can take them out into the world. These placements of where the heavy planets are at as well tells us a lot about how you think about yourself in relationships, or how you show up in social relationships. One of the biggest questions we're going to ask with a moon we're going to have in Virgo this month is, are you being a servant leader in your life, right? Because some of the good stuff that's going to come into your life, especially over March and April, is going to come from your interaction with others and their good graces coming towards you. So this is something to think about as we interact with this month, okay? All right, let's jump in and see what's going on the cosmic landscape. So first of all, at the beginning of the month, we have got Mercury, who is retrograde in the energy of Pisces, which Mercury in Pisces can also just feel like a little bit of a retrograde, because Mercury's not necessarily comfortable here. He wants facts and details, and he's not able to really get that in Pisces. Instead of being in the head, he's really got to drop down into the intuition. But Mercury's going to take the show on the road, continue the retrograde backwards into the energy of Aquarius, thus lighting up your fourth house space, okay? But here, Mercury is hyper-conversational, hyper-thinking, hyper-active a little bit here, because he's so grateful to be able to talk again. So you could be making decisions down here that have to do with your home, your family, your emotional security, your relationships, or maybe your connections with women. Now, because Mercury is still retrograde and has taken his path between two signs, it tells me something has been left undone and is looking for completion. So, you know, where does there need to be some healing, some refreshing in this home area for you? What is the connection with women in your life? It's come from the fifth house to the fourth house. Is there something going on with a younger child or a younger woman in your life that you're getting a new connection with? You're bringing new original energy to the table, new thinking to your table with this energy. Also, in the fourth house, this could just genuinely be property. Are you preparing? This third house is heavy. You could be wanting to buy or sell something, which I would not recommend you doing until Mercury is out of retrograde. But if you must, just go over the details, third house, to the best of your ability. But you could be going back over trying to buy or sell or do something different to your household. You'll have a stronger opportunity to do this at the end of the month once Saturn and Mars move over here. So we'll get to that, okay? Also, we've got Venus moving into the energy of Taurus over here, lighting up your seventh house space. So that's absolutely lovely. It brings you into a love and a social peak for the year. With Venus coming home into Taurus, it's very sensual. It's good food. It's delicious touching. It's massage. It's magnetic conversation. It's easily being able to socialize with people and feeling like the connections are really good. Now, Venus is also going to connect with this Uranian energy, and Uranus is unexpected. He's different. He's eccentric. It's like surprise. So maybe you've got some new connections in old relationships. right? Maybe you've just got some new connections, new romantic connections coming to your table. But remember, Uranus is not the most stable energy, right? But it is good at getting this area of your life out of a rut. But because Uranus does rule Aquarius, and Aquarius is in your fourth house, I tend to think this has something to do with relationships with family members or women or something like that, where you're making that connection and it feels like home, right? That's a wonderful, wonderful energy. Now, other things we do in relationships is we form business relationships. We're getting ready to come into Aries season, right? So this could be something that leads you to a business relationship on the other side of this energy. On the 9th, we're going to have a full moon happening up here in the energy of Virgo, lighting up your 11th house. So a full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. We need to create a shift happening here because the light is so big and so full, you're easily able to see that. So here in the 11th house, what you could be doing is re-looking at your friendship circles. You could be re-looking at connections that you have. But more so than that, because this is Virgo energy in a social house, I think that what could be happening for you is maybe you're starting a new social project or you're moving into an organization. It doesn't have to be a new organization. You could be moving into a new position in an old organization, or maybe you have a project on the table. This is opposite the fifth house, so children, a project of joy, something that's very childlike could be taking on a life of its own, but it's very big. Right? And so Virgo is going to help you scale that down and say, we just need to do one little step at a time. So this Virgo moon is certainly going to help you clean house and do it step by step. Virgo is also going to ask you, in how you show up in your social life, are you the smartest person in the room, Scorpio? Because if you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room. Where will you grow from there? What do you get to know from there? Or in your life, are you showing up as this servant leader, which says, I can do for you, because if I do for you, I also become done for as well. So it's an interesting balance to see, how are you serving in your life and also leading up here in this beautiful, detailed energy, okay? We've also got Mercury coming out of retrograde on the 9th. So cheers from everybody. This is great news. So any decisions you maybe wanted to make about buying, selling a house, a car, anything like that, you've got a little bit more security in signing those contracts and that paperwork. There could be conversation that's happening, like social conversation at your house. Maybe you're having a barbecue. I mean, it's nice. It's kind of getting nice, at least for some people where they live, it's getting nice. There's a whole bunch of snow here. So you could just be doing more social things coming to the table. Then on the 16th, Mercury is going to move over here back into the energy of Pisces in your fifth house, where the sun is shining and beaming, Neptune is being watery and brilliant over here, and Mercury is going to start to have the intuitive conversation of, are we happy? Am I happy? Am I joyful here? What does your intuition say? Mercury in Pisces becomes really very creative. So is there a creative third option to a challenge you've been in front of? Is this a time where you're just, it's, you know, maybe spring break, you're enjoying the kids, you're preparing for that in some way, shape, or form? This energy will help you in this area, okay? On the 20th, we've got the sun taking a shift, making a move up here into the energy of Aries. Now, the sun brings light, heat, life, vitality, and motivation. So in this sixth house realm, you are now motivated. So whether you are motivated to take on new health regimes, take control of your health, because remember, Aries is a cardinal energy. He's a beginning energy, and this is a warrior energy. You are going to start something. You are going to win at something. So is this that you want to win at your health, your daily routine? The third house is absolutely loaded and heavy. Have you, maybe even during the Mercury retrograde, put out a resume and now you're being invited to get a job opportunity, right? The prospects could be coming from there. Did you make a social connection at any one of these stops and now it's led you to a job or a project opportunity over here? I will tell you, Scorpio, if you own your own business and you have employees, this is a wonderful energy for checking in on your employees. How's everybody doing? How's everybody performing? Do I need to hire somebody? This is a cardinal energy. Maybe you've advanced enough that you actually need some help. or you're not making enough and it's time to cut it back. But begin whatever you need to and know that you've got motivation behind you. This day also is the beginning of the spring equinox for us in the northern hemisphere. In the southern hemisphere, you're going to be starting your autumn. So it is a new season of getting relationships, social skills, servant leader as a mind frame on your table and allowing these things to blossom out in your relationships and come back to you professionally, come back to you in your sibling relationships, come back to you in that book that you're writing, right? Any of these things give it a wildly big space to blossom. We've also got this very cool energy happening here where Mars and Jupiter are going to be in conjunction. Now, Mars and Jupiter together in conjunction is so very courageous. This is the energy of Capricorn, which is also a delicious cardinal energy, right? So it is grounded, though. This is a grounded cardinal energy for you to work with. So this is the day. If you want to buy that house, sell that house, buy that car, sign that contract, write that book, publish that book, get that website going, maybe have a conversation with your siblings about what's going on, this is the day where I will tell you, if you've been wanting to begin it, to start something, to take initiation, do it. You are in the energy of, please, let's just go for it, okay? On the 21st, we've got Saturn moving out of the energy of Capricorn and moving into the energy of Aquarius. And keep in mind that Saturn doesn't just rule Capricorn. He also, in traditional astrology, rules Aquarius as well. So he's just as comfortable here. He's just as at home in this area. But he doesn't act as concrete as he acts in the energy of Capricorn. Instead, he's going to move into the intellect. So Saturn is hovering above your life, looking at how to make it more future-minded, right? Where are we going to live in the future? Who are our social groups? But you're going to have to get serious about it, right? What's the community you live in and that your house is in and that you're building a life in? Saturn's going to help you get serious about it. If there's a property, if there are connections with women, if there is digital media you need to bring into your home to be able to work from home or something, Saturn's going to help you get very, very serious about looking over that area of your life. But it's going to come from a more intellectual place than the place of just being so concrete, okay? As we get towards the end of the month, then we're going to see Mars jumping in with Saturn as well. So you'll be taking a fair amount of action over there. And it's action that is built to take you to the next level and bring you freedom as well, okay? So I would tell you, if you don't have a tribe, if you don't have a social group, if you are just feeling like you need to connect with the ancient wisdom of your family line or your heritage or something, or if you're feeling like, I need to know how to do this thing, I need to know how to do this foundational psychological thing that allows me to be secure, you may be finding your answers on social media in some way, shape, or form, or in groups. And this is a wonderful energy to help you get that done. On the 24th, we're going to have a new moon happening in the energy of Aquarius. So, of Aries, excuse me. So this is exciting because not only is it in a cardinal sign, which is a beginning, and at the new moon, we plant our seeds of intention to begin something new or to give something a fresh look. So here in the sixth house, fresh health, new thinking about your health, new action. Aries is an action energy. So new actions in this area, new work, new projects, new opportunities to work and be that servant leader where you're at. Because remember, much of the good stuff that will come to you from March and April requires your action to kind of put other people first and serve them and connect with them. And then as we continue to travel throughout the year, you see the benefits of those connections. So I think it's going to be a very interesting month. I do want you from the 24th of the month where this new moon is here to just pay attention to your health, to include your mental health and your mental wellness. What's going on here? Has your attention been brought to something? And if it has, please, Scorpio, don't take long to pretend like something's not going on. Please don't take too long to pretend like you can fix it, right? If you have something that is presented to you here, please be serious about it and take control of that quickly, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you so much, and I look forward to seeing you next month, where hopefully you've been able to put that resume out, take on a new career opportunity, take that book and put it out there and turn it into something else. Whatever you desire, I hope you get to see the manifestations of it this month, okay? I love you guys. Bye.